The human genome is so complex that it has a code on top of it, the epigenome, which is an instruction manual so that the cells of the body can interpret the underlying DNA and activate genes when and where they are needed. The 23,000 genes are the recipes to create over a million proteins in the human body. While all the cells in the body have the same DNA blueprint, this second epigenetic code is distinct in each type of cell and controls when, where, and under what circumstances in the body a gene's protein recipe is required. The epigenetic code is written in the language of chemistry. It comprises different types of chemical tags added directly onto the DNA itself or onto the protein infrastructure that organizes and packs the DNA into the tiny nucleus of each cell in the body. Enzymes add and remove these chemical tags and open or close the double helix into an expanded or collapsed slinky structure. In the expanded state, the letters on the rungs of the DNA ladder can be interpreted by the cell to create a protein, whereas in the collapsed structure, the genes within the DNA code are invisible and silent. Unlike the stable, unchanging genetic code, our epigenetic code is dynamic, allowing responsiveness to both gradual and extreme fluctuations in the world around us. Near starvation conditions, lack of a vital nutrient in our diet, a new medication, or the life-threatening conditions of war. The impact of epigenetics on our biology and health doesn't end there. Over the past few years, science has described how we can inherit epigenetic adaptations from our grandparents and great-grandparents. Adaptations that allowed them to survive more effectively. For example, the inheritance of a predisposition to anxiety, if a grandfather suffered post-traumatic stress disorder as a result of war, or obesity if a great-grandmother lived through a childhood famine. If only there were a reset button to clear the epigenetic tags that no longer serve us. The good news is that lifestyle is under our control. We can change our diet, exercise, reduce stress, and seek out balance and harmony. All these positive changes trickle down and shift our epigenetic code to promote better health and vitality. There are indications that some types of positive health interventions, including a wide range of complementary medicines that are focused on improved well-being and which try to address the root of the problem, may be able to go further to promote epigenetic reset and boost positive health. They do this by identifying and resolving emotional stress and supporting the elimination of toxins that created the markers in the first place. Any healthcare technique capable of specifically resolving adverse epigenetic changes will have the potential to produce powerful health transformations. Modern biomedicine confirms these findings and encourages cutting-edge approaches. Traditional medicines around the world have been acknowledging the role of an individual's interaction between their inner and outer worlds and how that influences health and well-being for millennia. Chinese and Ayurvedic medicines especially focus on how our emotions, reactions to stressors, interaction with the environment, the health and well-being of our ancestors, the food we eat and how we eat it, and numerous other factors that are paramount in determining the loss of balance and harmony within a person. Could these approaches, or indeed any of the other complementary or alternative medicines, have something to offer in the quest to find interventions that can affect change on the epigenetic level? What is so exciting now in terms of the evaluation of healthcare techniques is that modern scientific research can be utilized for the examination of changes to the individual's epigenetic landscape. Employing commonly available analytical techniques, such as measuring the amount of messenger RNA via microarray analysis or real-time PCR, allows scientists to analyze the changes that occur within individuals and explore how they respond to health interventions. It is also possible to monitor other biophysical indicators of well-being, such as heart rate variability, or to apply some of the emerging methods that capture energetic change, such as energetic field imaging. By combining the advances of modern science with traditional knowledge that has been developed over thousands of years, great progress could be made towards human health and well-being, especially as we have taken ourselves far from the days of living in harmony within our communities and in balance with nature. Addressing the epigenetic inheritance after generations of pesticide use, pollution from coal and automobiles, as well as family destruction after the trauma of war or displacement, could be an important piece of the puzzle in combating chronic disease, social distress, and psychological disorders. Regardless of which healthcare approaches will eventually prove to be truly beneficial to humanity, what is known already is that we do not have to be prisoners to the inheritance within our DNA. We all have the capacity to change the way our genes are expressed. There are many ways we can do this. We can change our mindset and attitudes. We can change ourselves through the exercise we take and the eating patterns we employ. Through our engagement with all of our senses, through connecting with and supporting each other in relationship, and through the calming of our thoughts using meditative practices. We can draw on healing methods that enable us to connect with a sense of core wellness and inner radiance. By taking control and directing our own health, the skills of self-knowing, self-discovery, and self-compassion will allow us to make the changes that will help ourselves and future generations. Taking care of our thoughts, our communities, and ourselves just got a whole lot more important.